Have you ever realized, years after a breakup, that you were awful to the partner at the time and how did you cope? Realizing now that I sort of gaslighted her a bit when I always felt like I did a decent job of being a boyfriend. Learning from work and friends to shut up, take criticism, and conversation with them on how I can improve or learn from my mistakes. I realized a year after breaking up with my high school sweetheart, I broke up with him, that I was the main reason that relationship wasn't going anywhere. He always acted like he couldn't get anywhere without me, and that gave me a fat head, making me feel like I was a gift over him and he would do things and change for me because I was already so good to him. As you're looking back, I realized I never made him feel special or do anything to help build him up or motivate him to get his garbage together. We were young and he should, of course, be responsible for himself, but my attitude was never going to help things. I make a point now with my fiancé to show my support to him and make him feel special and tell him how attractive he is to me and make my feelings known, instead of just complaining at him when I want change and not making the effort myself and expecting results. Yes, 11 years on and I still get so much anxiety over it. He was the nicest guy you could ever meet, and I was a head case who broke his heart and said some horrible things. Years in therapy later, understanding my own demons has made things make sense. It's not an excuse, but I know more of why I acted that way. I keep wanting to contact him and apologize profusely, but I think it would be a bit too crazy. I'm sorry, Daniel, if you knew how many nights I literally lay awake hating myself. You'd know how truly sorry I am this year. Yes, I grew and became a better person. By tipping 30%, I used to criticize her for only being a waitress instead of using her intellect for good. My ex called me yesterday when he realized he'd been awful during our relationship. It was the most validating call I've ever gotten. I quit drinking. The ex I realized this about actually called me when I came across this post, things are alright and we are friends. That only happened after I put the bottle down. I don't think I've been awful, but I have come to terms with times I could have reacted better or handled things better. I always try to learn and grow from it so I don't react that way in the future. And if it's with someone I'm cool with after the fact, if appropriate, I offer them an acknowledgement and an apology. And #X200B. Other side of it, I was in an extremely emotionally abusive relationship with a guy, and the aftermath was so bad for my mental health that I had to move. He texted me out of the blue one day, married with a child on the way, to apologize for the way in which he treated me and that I didn't do anything to deserve it. About 4 paragraphs worth of apology. He made some excuses for his behavior with the whole "I was in a bad place" thing that I hear all too often, but it was the single most important healing moment of my life thus far. All the gaslighting and everything that happened prior to that, yeah, I felt better, even if he did it more for his own healing than mine. I don't care. Yes, the relationship was over 2 years ago, but I still haven't been able to date anyone else because the idea of me being like that again is crippling. Not years, but months. It took me being treated the way I treated him to realize, oh God, I was fluffing crazy. I'm coping by trying to be a better person and holding off on starting a relationship until I'm able to be that better person. Not 100%, but I realized that I did half the darnage. I coped by eating a pizza. I'm struggling with this right now. I'm besotted with my current partner and love him more than he'll ever know, but I still get these pangs of guilt whenever I'm reminded of how I behaved during my last relationship. I feel like I should have been a better girlfriend despite the fact that my ex could be a nasty piece of work at the best of times, and I don't have any feelings whatsoever for him now. I have to remind myself that if things had worked out, I'd have never met my current boyfriend, and that makes me feel better, but no less guilty. I'm hoping it will go away with time. We only split up a year ago. I try and be a much better girlfriend now. Not an awful person, but at the time I thought I was the best of partners. Looked back on it and realized that was certainly not the case. We are still good friends now and I apologized for being rubbish posthumously. I realized I was kind of whiny garbage bag at my wife when we were dating. Not sure why she stuck it out, but now I make it a point to be understanding, accommodating, and helpful so I'm the partner she can rely on. I grew up and am a much better person and partner. Years later, she has kids and everything. I'm married. We got back in touch and I apologized for how I was. Yeah, a big part was looking back and thinking on all the mistakes that were solely my fault. Realizing what my actions said about me. And seeing almost all of them could have been avoided by just being more present and considerate to my partner. The person I was with had a way of bringing out the worst in me since the beginning. So the biggest lesson I took from it was that you can't change people or what they do. You can only control your response to it. After about 10 years, when we had separate families and all jazz, I apologized. Yes, I will always feel like garbage. Quick note to say hi to everyone searching for their ex in here. 99.99% of you won't be able to write the "I fluffing told you so, Karen" response you've already typed out. Instead, you can write it here to me if it makes you feel better. Deleted. Yes, I tried to apologize. Months later, not years, and he basically said that he hoped saying that made me feel better, but he didn't want to ever hear from me again. I learned a really important lesson about the way I treat people and the fact that some things can't be fixed. Me and my ex had problems, but I look back and I'm sickened on how I acted. I became a better person and did a complete 180 on how I am. As here, it doesn't help the fact that she's gone and I know that she was the one. Well, my ex doesn't want to talk to me at all. I think it was entirely my fault. I try to be a good guy and respect women and people in general. Thing is that I didn't know how to handle my insecurities. I didn't communicate and I didn't thrive to improve the relationship. Also, I think I used her to forget about my problems and as a distraction. That's a big no-no. Worst thing is that I loved that girl, and as time goes by I am starting to think that maybe I loved what she was. Distraction, fun, and not her. By the way, the breakup was about 7 months ago and I don't have the drive or will to maintain a relationship with a few girls I really liked. Garbage is a bummer. Worst thing is that I didn't know that I was being garbage. That's the worst part. Yes. And sadly, since she cut ties, I feel I'd do more harm than good by trying to apologize. All I can do really is improve myself and make sure it does not happen again. With tremendous guilt and the strong will to never be that person again. Bethany, I'm sorry for who I was, and although we haven't spoken years and I doubt we will ever again, I was the garbage tea person you did not deserve. Renee, current GF, because of this I strive to be the great person you seem to think I am. As here, yes, we talked about what happened and I apologized. She told me she forgave me, but I still feel ashamed of it. I was awful to my ex. I didn't know how to deal with the situation I'd been forced to deal with. I was supporting her entirely throughout her heroin addiction. I didn't have any room in the relationship to discuss my own problems, because hers took up all the space in the relationship. I would lash out at her, and it was incredibly tumultuous. We would get into fights all the time about stupid garbage, and it wasn't healthy from either side. I was self-medicating with alcohol, and wasn't dealing with my depression, anxiety, or PTSD at all, until it was too late and I did things that I couldn't take back. I got violent with her one night. I've stopped drinking since then, and I have a therapist I go to. As time goes on, I'm starting to realize that I was the villain just as much as she was. I've asked for forgiveness, but that's not really good enough. I had to change my behavior. Otherwise, it would have been hollow. I'm not speaking to her, and haven't talked to her in roughly 6 months. I need space and time to work on myself. She's presumably doing well though. She's halfway through a nursing program and working a full-time job. These are things she was completely incapable of while we were in a relationship. So I'm incredibly proud of her. Thanks for asking.